Hey, DJ. Seeing everybody, cabin girl, I'm a little early. Thanks to my mods, you guys do a great job. Good seeing everybody. God bless. Good seeing you. Good seeing everybody. Pamela, good seeing everybody. you, Todd. Good seeing everybody. Melissa, good seeing everybody. Yvonne, God bless. Sissy, good seeing everybody. Radar. Lucy, good seeing you. David, good seeing you. Craig. Gina, God bless. Sissy, God bless. Good seeing you. Betty, good seeing you, Betty. Kathy, Freya, good seeing everybody. Shira, good seeing everybody. Lucy, I'll play one more song and then I'll get going. Good seeing you, Todd. Mary Wells, good seeing you. Etna here yet? Can't get started without Etna. Tina. I guess the bad weather went to West Virginia, I believe. So, praise the Lord, Ohio didn't get it. But pray for the people in West Virginia. Paradox, good seeing you, Kathy. Oh, guys, Christina, good seeing you. Thanks, Christina. God bless, Christina. Jim, good seeing you. Worm, Pamela, Bird, good seeing everybody. Kelly, Arkansas Traveler. Tina, God bless. Viral Saint, Stacy, God bless. Jackie, Martin. All, good seeing you. Tammy. William, God bless. Pamela, God bless. Mandy, God bless. Tammy. God bless. And up, God bless. Tammy. King, God bless. David, Delilah, good seeing you. Alice, good seeing you. Courtney, God bless. Laura, Canada. Are you ready? Beetle Dog, Sammy. Laughs a lot, God bless. Steven, KP, God bless. Kristen, God bless. Jackie, God bless. Escobar. Eric, good seeing you. God bless. Good job. Kathy, good seeing John Misa. God bless. There's people like John that told me that it's already started in Israel. Iran has been started to attack Israel already. There's people that told me that. I don't know if it's confirmed or unconfirmed, but the fact of the matter is it's going to happen tomorrow. They are like 7 hours ahead of us. They are 7 hours ahead of us. John and other people have sent me stuff about they already started. So as I said, it would happen on the 5th. It would happen on the 5th. If it hasn't started, it will start very shortly. And it will happen tomorrow. And the reason why I didn't go on earlier, we are watching for Israel to counterattack Iran. We are waiting for the counterattack. We are waiting for the counterattack. Israel will counterattack and hit Damascus. And I'll go over it in a minute. I'll play one more song. As I've been saying forever, watch Damascus, watch Israel. Been saying it for years. Tina, yes, I'm playing Isaiah 17. Exactly, Isaiah 17. I got it right here. Right here. Isaiah 17, correct? Correct. Isaiah 17, right here. I already talked about that, son of man. I already talked about that. It could be, it's gonna happen. DJ. seeing you. God bless. Cheryl, if I missed somebody, I'm sorry. Beetle, God bless. Kelly, good seeing everybody. Sharon's in here. God bless. Sharon, good seeing you. Cheryl, good seeing you. God bless. Todd. David the Watchman, God bless. Aetna, there you are. Good seeing you, Aetna. Betty, God bless. Barbara, God bless. Michelle, God bless. Judy, God bless. Lisa, Angela, God bless. Mathau, good seeing you. God bless, Sharon. Sign of his coming, God bless. Lizzie B, God bless. Good seeing you. God's girl. God bless. I'm going to get started. Good seeing everybody. As I said, I've been watching Damascus Forever. Last night, when I saw what Khomeini said, that's why everybody was reporting about with the I talked about right here, the Israel evacuates multiple locations, their embassies. As I showed here 19 hours ago when I said that Israel will be attacked on, they'll be attacked on the 25th, or on the 5th, April 5th, which is tomorrow, which it is already April 5th, they will be attacked tomorrow. Why everybody else was reporting about it is because of what I, Khomeini said, is or Iran's president Khomeini, what Khomeini said, CIA warns of attack on the Holy Lands. Everybody was reporting it. There was plenty of reports out there. Why the 5th, though? The reason why they knew this is what the Khomeini said, the president, and when he said something about storm on the mosque, Alaska storm. That's when it happened last time. He announced it before it happened, and he announced it this time. So I'm going to go over this in a minute. The stock market's been down 4 days in a row. It could crash tomorrow. It could crash on Friday, which is tomorrow. I talked about that many of times, about crashing on a Friday. Now, what we are waiting for is Israel to counterattack. Israel to counterattack. And I will go over it right now. This is what's going on right now. This is what's going on. This was 2 days ago. It's the fact of the matter is from October to now, Russia is in position. Russia is in the equation. Russia.
Welcome to Raptor News Channel. Israel did not expect this. Unexpected events occurred on the border. Russia and Iran responded to Israel's operations. Putin made bold statements. Additionally, Russian troops and tanks arriving at the border raised flags on the Israeli border. Numerous units are being deployed to the border. Things got complicated. Also, operations in the critical area in the center have been completed. Over 900 Hamas members were arrested in one go. If you're ready, let's quickly review the breaking news over maps and real footage. In recent days, tensions between Israel, Russia, and Iran have escalated significantly. The mutual support between Russia and Iran has stirred up the Middle East. While Iran provides Russia with numerous missiles and drones, Russia has started providing production and power support to Iran. Military bases and roads in Syria especially are being guarded by Russia. Iran is using these protected routes to launch consecutive attacks against Israel. For the past few days, Iran-backed militias have intensified their movements to the maximum level. Close to 100 vehicles have started shipments to the Israeli border within Syria. Attacks on Israel from Lebanon and Syria borders are carried out daily. Israel conducts daily airstrikes in the region to reverse this situation, targeting locations where Russia and Iran are present. Russia has grown increasingly uneasy about recent developments, which have presented a challenge to the world. In a surprising move, Russian soldiers raised the Russian flag on the Israeli-controlled Golan Heights border following orders from Putin. This event came as an unexpected surprise. Additionally, Putin's statements have exacerbated the situation, making it more critical. The situation is unfolding in a serious manner. Putin declared, "We are not only fighting for ourselves, but for the entire world."
Ashley, good seeing you.
He also expressed support for Gaza and Hamas, despite Russia's ongoing conflict with Ukraine. It is worth noting that Russian soldiers were recently stationed near the Golan Heights in Syria, with a Russian flag waving at the border. This was not a random event, but rather a conscious and professional endeavor. Soldiers and tanks were dispatched from military bases in Syria, and a flag was erected on the Israeli border. This was broadcasted on Russian television channels. In subsequent statements, Putin blamed the United States for the war in the Gaza Strip, saying, "This is a consequence of what the U.S. has done." In response to the United States sending aircraft carriers and warships to the region, Putin announced that Russia had taken its own precautions in the Black Sea region. MiG-31 fighter jets began patrolling the Black Sea continuously, and the situation has since escalated in both Syria and the Black Sea region. Returning to the Israeli border, today's Russian television broadcasted video footage of soldiers prepared at the Israeli border. The footage unmistakably depicts Russian soldiers taking positions on the front line and encroaching upon the Golan Heights. Among the countries calling for a halt to the Gaza war, Russia's actions exacerbate the complexities in the region. In the video provided by Russian television, both the Golan Heights and the Russian flag, alongside military units on the front line, are visible. This video is commonly interpreted as a message from Russian soldiers to Israel, suggesting the potential for Russian intervention in the area. However, it's crucial to remember that there is an ongoing Russian military presence near the Israeli border in Syria. In Damascus, there are numerous Russian bases situated close to the Israeli border. These bases are directly protected by Russian air defense systems. Russia exercises overall control in the region in return for providing arms to the Syrian government. As well, the Russian Foreign Minister, Sergei Lavrov, indicated that the Gaza and Israel conflict fosters unity in the Arab and Islamic realms. With this in mind, Lavrov's remarks suggested that Russia was prepared to assume a diplomatic part in the intensifying turbulence in the area. It's interestingly paradoxical that they assert these statements while simultaneously dispatching tanks to the perimeter. Certainly, Russia's recent communications and tactics have been quite memorable. The deployment of military forces close to Syria has the potential to change the dynamics in the region. In particular, Russia's presence in regions influenced by groups such as Iran and Hezbollah could impact the regional balance, potentially altering the power dynamics in the region. Russia's intervention in Syria has a significant impact on its relationship with the United States, particularly considering the ongoing conflict in Ukraine.
I could have played that too.
To Russia's support for Muslim and Turkish
I got Isaiah 17.
Gain lost influence. However, it is challenging for Russia to open a second front due to its limited military power and recent shortage of ammunition.
Bridget, God bless.
In response to the situation, Israel's stance is also of interest. The Israeli army is currently focused on dealing with Gaza, and it is unclear how many soldiers will be deployed to Syria. It is more likely that they will target military bases in Syria in retaliation rather than engaging in direct combat. Recent reports suggest that Iran has increased its shipments and constructed new fortresses in Damascus with the approval of the Syrian government. Israel may decide to target these new fortresses in response to Russia's actions. As a result, Russia's increase in military presence on the Israeli border and its political messages could influence the balance in the region and shape international relations. However,
Tina,
Russia's
God bless.
Limited military power.
Yeah, I know, Tina, sorry.
Shortage. Make it
I went early.
To open
Sorry.
A second front.
Good seeing you,
we
Tina.
We'll continue to closely monitor
Greatly appreciated.
The situation in the coming days. Next, our third report is from the center of Gaza. We mentioned yesterday that the operations at the Shifa Health Building were completed early in the morning. Israeli soldiers have been trying to clear the area around this building for about 10 days. Today, following the completion of the operations, the total numbers were shared. A total of 900 suspects were arrested
Glenn,
in
God bless.
And around the Shifa building. Through interrogations, it was confirmed that 500 out of these 900 individuals were directly Hamas members. Approximately 10 of these
Lord
500
is my shepherd,
members
God
held
bless.
High ranks and were involved in attacks on Israeli territories at the beginning of the war.
So, this states it. Israel's surrounded. They got Russia right at their doorstep. They planted their flag. What we are waiting for is the counterattack. What we would be waiting for is the counterattack. Israel is not going to stand for this. They are surrounded. We just sent them a bunch of fighters. We are going to get blamed for it, the United States. And then Russia will attack us. But this is the Jericho missile system. As it is right here, it's called the Doomsday Nuclear Option. This is what they are going to take out Damascus with. DJ sent me this. Behold, Israel said that they put these in place already. They're ready to go. They were going to do this. This was 5 months ago. They were going to do this. They were debating about doing this back in October. When the flood came, when they were attacked by Hezbollah, they were going to do this, but they didn't. But this time you have Russia into the equation.
A recent call by one Israeli lawmaker to deploy a doomsday weapon against Hamas and Palestine in the ongoing war has put the limelight on nuclear weapons in the region, namely the Jericho missile system. This week, an Israeli lawmaker called for her nation's military to use nuclear warfare in response to attacks by Hamas. Revital Tali Gottlieb, a member of the Knesset for Israel Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu's Likud party, posted multiple posts on X advocating for a forceful retaliation following a surprise attack by Hamas. The call for the use of the Jericho missile system comes as more than 2,200 combined Israelis and Palestinians have been killed in the ongoing war against Hamas. What is the Jericho Ballistic Missile Program? Gottlieb specifically mentioned Jericho in reference to Israel's initial ballistic missile program developed in the 1960s and named for the biblical city. While the program was formed with French aerospace company Dassault, France withdrew in 1969 and Israel maintained the system and had the solid fuel Jericho 1 model ready in 1973 during the Yom Kippur War. The Jericho 1, which was retired in the 1990s, had a weight of 6.5 tons, a length of 13.4 meters, and a diameter of 0.8 meters, according to the International Institute for Strategic Studies. It had a range of 500 kilometers and could carry a 1,000 kilogram payload, though it had a 50% chance of hitting within a 1,000-meter radius of its target. Israel later developed the Jericho 2, a longer-range missile in the late 1980s, with a length of 15 meters and a diameter of 1.35 meters, while maintaining the same payload capacity. It had a range between 1,500 and 3,500 kilometers. The Jericho 3, an intermediate-range system, was introduced years later and was reportedly tested in 2008, entering into service in 2011. It featured improvements over the previous models with a longer length than the Jericho 2 and a larger diameter of 1.56 meters. It is not yet clear if Jericho 3 has been deployed by Israel during the ongoing retaliatory offensive against Hamas.
This was 5 months ago, but this is what they're going to use. And behold, Israel said that they're in place right now. So they are going to protect themselves from Russia. And this is in the Bible. I'll go over it in a minute. It says, what is a Jericho doomsday missile? This is an article on it. This is what they're going to use. This is what Israel's going to take out Damascus with. As you can see, this is another article. As I showed you in the video, that was 2 days ago. This was 17 hours ago. Russia strengthened military presence in Syria, Golan Heights. Israel and Iran tensions intensify. Now, this is why I knew that it was going to happen on Friday. This is why everybody was saying that about Iran's getting ready to attack. It's called Quds Day. This year's Quds Day will be an international outcry. This is Quds Day. He had a video on it. He was talking in front of all the military. This is Quds Day. This is tomorrow. This is Friday. It's Friday there already. It's called the flood. Will be likened to the flood. This is the flood that they talked about in October. They did in his speech. He talked about Alaska Mosque flood, which happened in October, which is what started everything. It says right here, it's Iran's supreme leader has declared this year's Quds Day, which is Friday, which is tomorrow for them, which is right now actually for them. They're about 6 or 7 hours ahead of it. It's going to be their it's going to be a flood. He said that it's going to be like no other. He said this is why everybody has been talking about it. The Alaska floods, that was on Friday. This is when they started shooting rockets into Israel. This is when the fireworks happened. And then Israel counterattacked and attacked the Golan Heights. It was the same thing. As you can see, a flood, Alaska flood. This was on October 7th. This was the first invasion of Israel territory. This was the first. This is Alaska flood. In his speech, he's talked about it. Right here. He's calling for a global jihad day. Right here. They're calling for global jihad day on Friday. Right here, Quds Day is April 5th. And this is what he was talking about in his message. It says right here, empower Palestine's cause. It says, this year, Quds Day falls on April 5th, which is the last Friday of the Islamic holy month of Ramadan. It's always on the last Friday. And it says, it is officially known as International Quds Day and is annually Palestine event held to empower the Palestine and oppose Zionists. The name of the Islamic name is called Quds. So this is Friday, and he was talking about this in his speech, and that's why I knew, and that's why everybody said that in the flood, when the flood happened in October, when all the rockets started flying, he announced the flood before it happened, the same thing that happened is happening this time. Not only the embassies, they're calling everybody home from the embassies. The police has banned Jews from Temple Mount during the final days of Ramadan. This was on April 3rd. They did this right before they bombed Damascus. They shut down Temple Mount. Why? Because they know that there's going to be a lot of stuff going on. So they banned it. Israel issues maximum level alert on embassies worldwide as diplomats evacuate, report says. Why are they evacuating? Because they know that all H is going to be broke loose. That's why. Here it is. The leader of the revolution is this evening. The defeat of the Zionist regime in Gaza will continue, and this regime will close decadence and desperate efforts like they did in Syria will not save them from their failure. Of course, the slain will be eaten this action as well. This was the, said that there would be the quids day. He had a long speech, and he was from military. And this is why around the world they're expecting things to happen around the world, and this is on Friday. Says right here, it says Quid Day was only observed in Islamic countries, but this year it will be around the world, he said. He also... He also said in here that it would be like no other. This Quids Day would be like no other. So in other words, he was making threats. And he said that it will be like a flood. And he said just like what happened 6 months ago with the flood. He said, I'm paraphrasing, but that's what he said. He had a long speech. It was over. And that's why everybody's saying that they're getting ready to attack. Which, as you can see here, Israel's taking their threat maximum level alert. They are taking their threat seriously, let's say. Says right here, Quids Day will be an international uprising against the upsurging Zionist regime, which that's Israel. He also said that it'd be like a flood, which I showed you in that one article, which he was referring to what happened in October. So that's why they're taking it seriously. So, as I said, there's many verses about Damascus, and I've played these before. I've been watching Damascus forever, and it's actually Isaiah 17, and I'll play it right here. What I'm wondering if this shall happen, because I know Tim, Brother Tim, has called this fortress a ship, which it could be. Ships are called fortresses. This is an aircraft carrier. We have two aircraft carriers in the Middle East right now. And Brother Tim has always said that that was an aircraft carrier, and it could be. I believe that could be. The Eisenhower and the Ford are in the Mediterranean right now. Says they will be taken away. So we'll see what happens there. But here's the verse, and I'll play it.
Isaiah 17, the burden of Damascus. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be a ruinous heap. The cities of Aroer are forsaken. They shall be for flocks, which shall lie down, and none shall make them afraid. The fortress also shall cease from Ephraim, and the kingdom from Damascus, and the remnant of Syria. They shall be as the glory of the children of Israel, saith the Lord of hosts. And in that day it shall come to pass that the glory of Jacob shall be made thin, and the fatness of his flesh shall wax lean. And it shall be as when the harvest man gathereth the corn, and reapeth the ears with his arm. And it shall be as he that gathereth ears in the valley of Rephaim. Yet gleaning grapes shall be left in it, as the shaking of an olive tree. Two or three berries in the top of the uppermost bough, four or five in the outmost fruitful branches thereof, saith the Lord God of Israel. At that day shall a man look to his Maker, and his eyes shall have respect to the Holy One of Israel. And he shall not look to the altars, the work of his hands, neither shall respect that which his fingers have made, either the groves or the images. In that day shall his strong cities be as a forsaken
SDL, God bless. Good seeing you, Ken. David.
Which they left because Pearl. Of the children of Israel, and there shall be desolation. Because thou hast forgotten the God of thy salvation, and hast not been mindful of the rock of thy strength, therefore shalt thou plant pleasant plants, and shall set it with strange slips. In the day shalt thou make thy plant to grow, and in the morning shalt thou make thy seed to flourish. But the harvest shall be a heap in the day of grief and of desperate sorrow.
Carly, good seeing you.
Woe to the multitude of many people which make a noise like the noise of the seas, and to the rushing of nations that make a rushing like the rushing of mighty waters. The nation shall rush like the rushing of many waters, but God shall rebuke them, and they shall flee far off, and shall be chased as the chaff of the mountains before the wind, and like a rolling thing before the whirlwind. And behold, at evening tide, trouble, and before the morning he is not. This is the portion of them that spoil us, and the lot of them that rob us.
Stella, God bless. So, like I said, we would expect that Israel's not going to do nothing unless they are attacked. And like I said, some people are reporting that it started already. Maybe it didn't. But from what the Israel leader's talking about, it's going to happen. It's going to happen on the 5th. It's going to be happening all around the world, and we'll see what happens. This is what he was saying. This is why everybody's saying it would happen very shortly, but he's saying that it will start on Quids Day, and it will be like a flood. Right here, he said it would happen as a flood, and this happened. This is when the missiles started flying in October. So in his speech, he was talking about it's going to be a flood, as it was 6 months ago, he stated. In his speech, it was over an hour. So, like I said, that's why This would be right on schedule too, because if something happened in the Middle East, then our stock market would crash on a Friday, of course. We could get a cyber attack. This would cause a cyber attack. This would cause everything to start happening. This is also an IPEC GOAT too. It shows the rockets with the eclipse. Now, Israel could happen with Damascus before the eclipse and then the United States after. It also shows the Statue of Liberty falling, as I have showed before, and other people. And it shows the Star of Israel, shows their flag. So, and in, as I said, in Isaiah 17, it says the fortress from Ephraim will be taken away from a city, which that is, could be the aircraft carriers. There's also the flying fortress, which is also, I think, the B-52 bombers, but I don't think they would be taken away. Right here is the missiles. And I know that Biden didn't renew restoring, replenishing our supplies. And it shows the star right here, Israel and the United States. And I wanted to say the Statue of Liberty got hit by lightning today. I don't know if you've seen that, but here it is. The Statue of Liberty got hit by lightning. I don't know if you heard about it or seen it, but here it is. So, good seeing everybody. And we're at the end. And keep looking up. Good seeing everybody. Thanks to my mods. I went earlier because most people wanted me to go earlier. And I figured, yep, I'll go earlier. Plus, there was reports that Israel was attacked. But it could be, it might not be, but there was reports of it. So, good seeing everybody. God bless. Keep looking up. Sweet Pea, good seeing everybody. G, good seeing everybody. Jules, good seeing everybody. If I miss somebody, I'm sorry. Keep looking up. It's not going to be long. But this is what we should expect to happen. So, anyway, people are sending me stuff right now. I'll check it out. But good seeing everybody. Thanks to my mods. You do a great job. Thanks for making it. Good seeing everybody. Thanks. I will be live Saturday morning. We'll see what happens there. Today's almost Friday. So good seeing everybody. Got a minute. Good seeing you. Kathy, Rapture 111. Good seeing everybody. It won't be long. God bless.